I like to make music. Sometimes I make music with my computer, sometimes with a tablet, sometimes with a phone. Sometimes I tap a key, a pad, or a screen. The mood or inspiration will strike whenever. And this year, I've promised myself to write more music, a lot more. So to be able to accomplish that, you need flexibility. Something to have with you when a screen on its own isn't enough. This is the Irix Key IO25 from IK Multimedia. I bought this to help me achieve this goal. Is it any good? Well, I've had this for a few weeks, and I think I know now. This is a review, but I'm not one for listing endless technical specifications. They have a website for that. For me, this is about it being a tool, something fun and musical. I bought the 25 key version as I wanted something portable, in a bag, on my lap, wherever. The full-size keys are great, and I'm pleased with the key action and sensitivity. Out of the box, it works great with IK Multimedia software such as the excellent Syntronic that I use with both Mac and the iPad. All the synths you can hear in this video, I wrote using those sounds. Along the top, there are numerous controls, not too many, but good enough to get some real expression from your sounds. The pitch, bend and mod controls are on sliders. They are super responsive but take some getting used to. They are fun to use. In the middle you have five rotary dials. One is a data control for selecting different sounds which can be pushed in to make a selection. The other four controls can be assigned for whatever you want, whether it's ADSR, filters or other parameters. I say four controls. The alt button actually gives you the option to have a second bank of controls, so potentially there are eight things to control. Moving along, we've got eight pads. Use these for drums or to control other MIDI parameters if you want. But so far, there's nothing much to differentiate this from many other cheaper MIDI controllers on the market. That is, until you use the built-in audio interface. On the back is an XLR and jack combo input with gain control and phantom power, and this phantom power will work even when the keyboard is running off batteries. So if I want to record the sound of a synth over audio, vocals or another instrument, I can. And I don't need another box to carry around to do it, it's all here. And it sounds great. Hook up headphones, hook up monitors, the flexibility is all there. All in all, it's seriously cool. It's not perfect though. I do have a wish list. I hope that a future version of this will come with two inputs so I can record in stereo if I need to. I hope IK Multimedia consider shipping a power supply with this instead of charging extra. I hope somehow a standard USB cable could be used instead of a proprietary cable, spares of which aren't cheap. But despite my wish list, it's still fun, flexible and musical. It'll help me achieve my goal of writing whenever, wherever. I'll finish by saying something I discovered whilst using this keyboard, something unexpected. I've been a pianist for over 20 years, and in that time, when I write music, I fall into habits, I play a certain way. With a 25 key controller, it's presented interesting challenges. If I want to play a ninth chord with a bass note in the left hand, that isn't really possible with this. Instead, you figure out different ways of playing. Using inversions, moving away from the root note in the bass, using suspensions, and other chord variations to make it sound interesting. Instead of relying on the old faithful habits, this keyboard has presented challenges. It's asked me questions as I write. Could I play this differently? Could I make this more interesting? It's often said that creative limitations inspire further creativity. This might be the case here too.